Hello, welcome. It's me, Table. Here we are, number three. The last one. The last one before tomorrow, 29th, 25th April, being the new meta release date, right? Right? So in the meantime, here we are respawning in 3 days' time. What have we got in this JPEG? Blue base shield. Okay. Spawns. Defense zone. The tower. Okay. Respawning. This review is focused on the details of respawning. Safe zone, defense zone. The image above shows the actual size of the fusion shield and a set of spawn locations inside the shield, known as the safe zone points, and an area outside the fusion shield known as the defense zone. If there are no enemies inside your shield, then you will spawn in on a safe zone point. If there are enemies inside your fusion shield, you will spawn in the defense zone facing your base. Right, okay, that makes sense. Where are we? Defense zone facing your base. This will allow you to pick up a strategic location to defend your base from, or join teammates to do a quick counterattack of the fusion tower, perhaps. Random selection. Your spawn location within the zones is selected semi-randomly. We choose random as we wanted to reduce spawn camping by making it difficult to predict where enemies may spawn. We do make sure the location chosen is valid location to spawn at, i.e., so you don't spawn right on top of another ally, for example. We also did it this way as we wanted to start with something simple and see how the aspect of gameplay developed before layering in complexity where it is required. Fine. Respawn time. There are two mechanisms that determine how long you will need to wait to respawn. BT, battle time, i.e. the time that has passed in the battle. OL, your overclock level. The higher level, the longer your take to respawn when you die. Yeah, okay. Respawn times are multiplied by 1 at the start of the battle and by 3 at the end of the battle, 30 minutes in. Respawn times are 5 seconds for OL1 and 30 seconds for OL13. So if you are OL13 and you are 30 minutes into the battle, your respawn time will be 90 seconds long. 90 seconds. Yeah, not so keen on that. Respawn time, but what else could they do, I suppose? The respawn times get long at the end of the battle, to ensure that there are long enough windows of opportunity for enemies to attack your towers and reactors when the key kills are made to ensure the game ends in a timely way. Fair enough. When players dying or quickly taking longer to respawn at the end of the game, things get very dangerous and the end game always happens. Fine. Elective respawn and clock cycle denial. Players will be able to elect to respawn at any time by pushing escape, but the respawn cooldown timer prevent this if you're being shot and taking damage. So if you can only electively respawn if you haven't taken damage for 15 seconds, we have increased the cooldown time to 15 seconds. Smart. Yeah, that's smart. So like, you know when you shoot someone and they run away and they just leave the game and it kind of sucks? Not a nice tactic. Now they've not got to be hit for 15 seconds, so you can chase them down more effectively. That's good. Elective respawn to deny enemies from overclocking by killing you or to rush back to base in the early game are acceptable strategies in the new meta. Elective respawn to deny enemies from overclocking by killing. Okay, so they are effective strategies. Okay, but remember, you'll not earn clock cycles whilst you are waiting to respawn. True. Example tactic. You will notice an undefended fusion tower in the early game and start to destroy its plutonium, but you notice enemies are approaching. You self-destruct and respawn at your base before you get shot on you choosing that the 10 second respawn time hit and loss of clock cycles are well worth the 20% you knocked off the health of the enemy's tower. That is a good tactic. Okay, that's a good tactic, yeah. Get in quick, shoot the tower, you see the enemies, you run, you respawn. Nice. Okay, that's nice. That's nice. Right, so there we go. Respawning explained. I've been Table. Thanks so much for watching. If you've enjoyed what you've seen here today, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Also, if you're not already, no, stay charm. Doesn't matter if you're not already. If you don't know already, you don't know. It doesn't matter. What am I saying? I'm rambling. Stay charm. I'll see you again soon in another video. I've been Table. And also, most importantly of all,